Hello, good day everyone. My name is Luis Gandara. I am the developer for Gtrend Futures and Gtrend Spot for Gunbot. Now, this video, I will explain how to set up Gtrend Futures for Bybit for the first time. Now, make sure you already have your Gunbot installed already with your exchange APIs from Bybit. Now, Gtrend Futures can be adjusted and set up in different ways. In this video, I will explain how to set up the basic way, which is with the default values of 24-hour time frame. First, you will need to set in Bybit Exchange the cross-mode leverage. I use 10x as well. You will have to set hedge mode true. Now, next thing, you will need to go to add pairs. After you have selected the section for add pairs, the exchange, make sure you have already your account set up correctly. I'm using linear unified, and then you go to add pair, you go to USDT pairs, and you select the pair you wish to add. Here we will be adding XRP. Once we have selected it, you want to go and select under the community dev tab, you want to select Gtrend Futures. Once you have selected it, you have it selected, you want to go to add pair. After you have selected and clicked on the add pair section, go ahead and save and start trading. When using for the first time, I recommend you start with a pair with a small unit cost minimum entry of less than 8 USD dollars, like XRP or Dodge, for you to see how it works. Then after you see how the strategy works, you can always increase the trading limits or max position value, as well as decrease the time frames, which will result in a lot more scalping in smaller time frames. It is very important to only trade or select pairs with at least 50 candles in order for the bot to trade correctly. When you hit save and start the bot, the auto configuration will start and it will populate all values needed automatically. Mm-hmm. You will see the first time pair running value going into false automatically. This will also add both sides, the long and the short pair, and it will populate all values. It will take a couple of minutes for this to happen. Once it's done, all values, you will see these values, like for example, the free money period, the trading period, or the reduction period. Once you see these values populated on your settings, this means that the pair will soon start trading. Now, when running for the first time the bot or the strategy, it is recommended that you send a buy and sell order from the trading terminal from Gunbot to make sure that you are connected correctly with the exchange and you have the right settings for your futures API settings from your exchange. After you have sent both orders, the long and the short order, you will see that they are populated and you will see both positions in your Gunbot instance. Now, I recommend you send them for $8, which is the same amount we will be using as default. Once you have sent both positions, the long and the short, to test your API and connection with Gunbot, you will see them both populate and you will see both squares as well as the support and resistance values in your chart. Once that's done, you can always close it and that's it. It will be up and running and happy trading. Now, after you have set up your bot and it's up and running correctly, Now you can increase the amount of pairs or the trading volume, which is your trading limit, or you can increase the amount of times you want the pairs to be able to hedge. Now, always very important, make sure that you don't add more than 4 pairs per instance, or else you will get rate limited by the exchange, which will cause problems with your trading bot. Now, I will explain how to change 3 important settings which determine the time frames that it trades on, the amount of hedges that could happen, which is the max position value, as well as the trading limits. Now, it is very important to understand how the hedging happens, how the hedging works. That way you can increase the amount of times you wanted to hedge, or you can always increase the trading limit, or as well the amount of pairs that you are running. Just keep in mind they only want to add a maximum of 4 pairs. Now, in example 1, which is the default value, if you're using 8 on both sides trading limit, it will hedge 5 times prior to getting to 200, which is the default max position. That's the normal that runs on the 24-hour time frame, which is the daily time frame. Now, example 2, let's say you increase the both sides initial trading limit to 80, it will hedge twice before reaching the 200 value, which is not good because it's only twice that it'll hedge. Now, example 3, I like it. It's another way to trade. If you have your both sides initial trading limit, which is 8, and it starts from there, and let's say you want to increase your max position up to 20,000 US dollars, it will open 12 hedges, which is 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512, 1024, 2048, 4096, etc. until 32,768. Now, this is a different way to approach it. This will be more active because you will get to hedge many more times. Now, this is all done on the daily time frame. If you want to decrease the time frame, it works pretty good, because it will increase the amount of times it will trade, because it will get more opportunities more often. Now, let me explain how that works. Okay, now in this picture, it shows the both sides initial trading limit of 8. That's our starting point. That's our first trade. The next trade, it will be for $16, which will be a short. Now, let's say the market reverses right there. It will go up until $32 and it will open a $32 long. Let's say it reverses again. It will open up a $64 short. Now, let's say it gets close to take profit, but it reverses prior to taking profit. A Gunbot or G-Trend, automatically it knows where to close that position in order to try to take advantage of a reversal. Now, this you could say is part of a black box, it's internal, but a G-Trend doesn't only just hedge, it works for it looks for reversals, which could be the most profitable trades. Now, G-Trend is constantly looking at the trends, and it does a different type of long support resistance as well as the short support resistance. Those are based on trends, lower lows and higher highs. This means that it doesn't just follow the price action, which makes it a lot better. Now, in this example, for example, if the max position was 600, it will trade up to 1024 before it reaches max position. Now, if you want to change the period on which Gunbot or G-Trend futures it's trading, you will need to change any of these 3 periods. Each one has its own time frame, you would say. Now, for example, the free money period, which will open the both sides initial trading limit 1 time Maximum, it will DCA another time. It will open a second position on the same side. This is the only time it will happen. If you see for some reason Gtrend, it's only trading one side, it opens multiple positions at one side. It could be, for example, that maybe WebSockets is turned on, which currently is not used in the strategy, or it could be that you're getting rate limit. So it will just open one time, maximum two. Once it opens the second position for a hedging, it will move to the second, to the trading period. That one, for example, if we set it to 60, it will trade all the hedging in the 60 minute time frame. Now, once you reach max position, once you have opened the last hedge on the max position, that's when it gets to the reduction period. Now, it won't reduce your position. Gtrend goes into a more in-depth trading style, trying to fish an exit without reoccurring to adding more funds to the original already opened up position. So in other words, if you reduce the time frames, it will trade a lot more often, almost like scalping. It will be more constant gains, but it can result in reaching the max position value a lot sooner. Using higher time frames, which personally I like the default value, which is the 24 hour time frame, that works pretty good. But that's where you would probably need to use more pairs. Using less smaller time frames, like the 1 hour, the 4 hour, or the 6 hour, or the 12 hour, it will result in more better trades. This means that not that much noise. Using a small time frame like the 60 minute time frame, it really will result in a lot of trades, more constant profits, but it could get locked into the max position time frame zone. And on the max position, it locks itself, so it won't trade that much in that state. So it's eventually Gunbot, the strategy will do its best to get out of that situation without adding more. But at the end, you wanna test a little bit of both. But in reality, I personally like in between, you would say, 4 hour, or maybe the 6 hour. That's a good value to have it in. And using smaller time frames and increasing the max position, that also could work pretty good. The thing is, you don't want to add that many pairs, because eventually, after so many hedges, that position is going to grow.